know, first of all, the aggregates are taken from the stockpiles. These aggregates are fed into these food bins. Now, you know, there are many types of aggregate used in for the development of this part. So these cool bins are having the same number of sequence-wise the parts for the feeding of the aggregates. Like this example, I will just give you 32 to 20, 20 to 10, 10 to 5, and 5 to 0. You may use one bin for this one, second bin for this one, third bin for this one. But you know, this material is too much use. You can use two bin for this one. Now, how the bin looks like? So just for your introduction, I will not make it very much wood sketch, just for your, I will just show it to you. These will look like this one. Now, their aggregates are put into these bins. From these bins, the aggregate will come out. So this is the opening gate of each bin. And it is the control gate. Whatever the aggregate can be controlled by this is the system over here. So first of all, when these aggregates, there are two provisions. Directly these aggregates can be made to fall on the bed. And second, sometime we have a feeding belt under each one. This is our feeding belt and feeding belt. All these aggregates are made to fall on the feeding belt. And this feeding belt then drop the aggregate to the other belt, other conveyor. So this feeding belt are the, this is having variable speed. The amount of aggregate coming out from these bins depends upon the control, how much control you have given to discharge. So this is a very important point to remember. So all the aggregate coming out from these bins depend upon the opening. How much opening is given over here, then these aggregate will fall over to this one, and from this feeding bin the aggregate is made to fall and other type of this bed. So in this way, as we have the control system over here, we can get the controlled amount of aggregate falling on this one. So for all these aggregates which are falling, we have to transfer it. For this transferring of these aggregates, after this cooled bin system, we are using another system known as the this conveying system is falling into two types. Conveying system. This conveying system is falling into two types, as I look. First one is known as a gathering conveyor. And second one is known as a discharging or charging conveyor. See this one, still I have not deleted this one. Aggregate from each bins, from this opening gate, either fall on this feeding bed or directly falling on this main conveyor. This main conveyor which I have shown over here, this is known as a gathering conveyor. Aggregate coming from this one going, aggregate coming from this one going, aggregate coming from this one going down, aggregate coming from this one going down. So in this way, I can just, for your introduction, for your understanding, I can say this aggregate are accumulated over here. Aggregates are accumulated over here from the different sizes. Now, these type of the aggregates are gathered. So that is why from this gathered word, we have derived this word known as the gathering conveyor. Now this conveyor is not a constant, it is moving, it's not a stagnant, it's not in the stopping position. It is continuously moving with constant speed. So means that this aggregate which is being load over this one, it is moving. Its speed is constant, but the amount of discharge from these bins or the amount of this material falling on this bin, this can be discontrolled in our own hand. Its speed can be increased or decreased. Means amount of material passing on this bin can be increased or decreased. So this gathering conveyor will transfer all of this material to the other conveyor. And that conveyor, just for your introduction, I will show it to you. It will be like this one. So from this gathering conveyor, all these material is transferred to this one. Now this conveyor is going to transfer this material to the other component, very important component known as the drive. Okay, other very important component of our asphalt patching plant is the drive. Now the question is, what is the drive? What is its function? So before we start, what is the function? So let me tell you, this dryer is like this one. If you see this one, it shows that it is a cylindrical shape. It's not a straight, it is in the inclined position. And it is continuously keep on revolving during the operation. During the revolving, the aggregates are revolved inside. So from this is the at higher position, this one is at the lower position. Aggregates are fed into this one from this side. Like this. This is our aggregate. And these aggregates are in the form of rotation inside due to the rotation of this aggregate, this plant to this drive. So that's why we can say that when the aggregates are entering from this point, then aggregates are coming out from the other side. So this is the discharge point. So that is why it is known as the inclined. It's not a state, it is always situated at some certain angle. So this is our position where aggregates are put into this one, and this is our position where aggregates are discharged out. Second thing which I want to tell you, at this point, this low point, we have one system known as the heating system. And this heating system, its temperature can be controlled. How much temperature we want to keep it? This is our ignition point at this one. Now this fire, we have to spread it inside. Like this one. Now the fire is, these are the fire slips going into this one. This fire system can be either by the fuel or by the gasoline. Now how this fire is reaching to the farthest point? It means there is some air inject system. If some air system is over there, this air system push the air, this fire to be go more deeper into this one. So that's why this is the brief introduction about this one. And how much temperature we have to maintain inside this one, it is always in our hand. Because this, it is the fire which is inside, it is a controlled fire, it is not an uncontrolled fire. When it is a controlled fire, it means the temperature inside can be adjusted maximum it is understood that we always try to maintain 165 Celsius temperature for these aggregates which are being heated. Now the question is, why we are doing this practice? Answer is very simple. For our asphalt mix, there should not be any moisture retained on the aggregate. So its first function, it is removing all types of the moisture from the aggregates. And second, as we know, for the development of hot mix asphalt, certain temperature is required. So it is heating the aggregate to the desired temperature of mixing. So these are the two very fundamental principles, and how it is putting this material out. This is our exit point. From this exit point, the aggregates are taken to the next stage.